of a partner. I ain't got no time for your shenanigans. I'm tryna make it into heaven. I ain't got no time to be playing with sin. You can mess me with all that, boy.
Hello, boys and girls, and happy Father's Day to all the dads that are watching. Today is going to be a pretty good lesson about a widow. This widow, she did not have a lot of money, but she had a whole lot of faith. And Joe is going to tell us all about the story. And before we count down for our favorite song, I have some guests I want to bring over. Come on, girls. Come on over. Come on over. And so, back up right here. We're about to sing the story time song. You ready?
Yeah.
3, 2, 1. I think it's story time. I think it's story time. I think it's right on time. I think it's story time with Joe and the crew.
Good morning, Kingdom Kids. It's story time with Miss Joe, and I'm so excited to do this story with you today. Today we're going to talk about Elijah and the widow. Are you ready? Let's go. There was a widow and her son who lived in the town of Zarephath. Now, a widow is a person whose husband has died, so it was only her and her son, and they were very, very hungry. In their town, it had not rained for many, many, many days. So one day, the widow said, "I am just going to go and collect some wood because I am going to make one last meal for me and my son, and we are going to die." Did you hear me? They were going to die because they did not have any food. Well, while she was out, a prophet named Elijah asked her for some water. As she was about to get him some water, he also asked her for some bread. Now, if you heard me before, you know that she does not have enough food, only for her and her son. But he convinced her to make him some bread anyway. She thought about it because he said that God would provide. So she went back in her home and she wanted to do what was pleasing to God. So she got some flour and she got the little oil that she had left, and she began to mix it in faith because she knew that God would do what he said that he would do. And as she finished mixing it, she put it in the oven and she waited, because sometimes fate has you waiting. And as she waited, she wanted to make sure that her and her son had something to eat. And guess what? God did provide. When it came out, she had enough bread for her, her son, and Elijah. And guess what? Because of her obedience, God made sure that she always had enough food to eat. He said that she would always have enough flour, great value, and enough oil. So today we want you guys to know that if you're struggling with your faith, that God will always provide. Say, God will provide. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed that story time. See you next time. Bye. Good morning, Kingdom Kids. I have my Kingdom Kids praise team with me. And we want to invite you to have a worship experience with us today. Please get off those couches and join us in worship. Are you guys ready?
Yeah!
Let's go!
Will you put that in this atmosphere? The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? Whom shall I be afraid? We're going to sing a song. I'm going to teach you to tonight.
The Lord.
Who shall I fear?
Yeah.
Kirk.
Chloe.
And Kurt.
And we are the Coleman family.
And I have my peanut kids with me.
I have
Micah.
Alana.
Alex.
And Holly.
Holly, are you guys excited to be with us today?
Yes.
Well, I'm so excited to have them with us today. Scripture, Hebrews 11:1. Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. My message today is, all it takes is a little bit of faith. Let's go.
All it takes is a little bit of faith.
One more time.
All it takes is a little bit of faith.
All right, so today we're going to talk about faith and what does it mean to have faith. All right, guys, put on your thinking caps. Who knows something about faith? What is faith, Kylie?
Faith is like something you believe in. Like you believe in God, but even though you can't see him, you know he's there.
Oh my God. Faith is believing even if you cannot see him. Say, I can't see him.
I cannot see him.
I still believe.
But I still believe.
Anybody want to add on to that? What is faith? What do you think, Chloe?
Faith is something like I can't see air, but I can still feel it, or like I still believe in it.
Oh my gosh, they are on it today. She said, I can't see air, but I can still feel air. And that's what faith is. Sometimes we are not able to see everything that we believe in, but in our hearts, right? We know that it's real. Say, God is real.
God is real.
Anybody else want to add on with faith? What do you think, Alana?
Faith is something that you can't see, but you know it's there.
You know it's there. Anybody have any more examples? No, not yet? All right, so today we're going to talk about faith, but I am going to teach it using our five senses. Say five senses.
Five senses.
Now, let me see. Who knows what the five senses are? Anybody, Kylie?
Your ears, your nose, your...
Oh, you just can do one, Kylie. Give everybody else a chance. What's one five sense? Sight, right? What do you think?
Your mouth.
Taste. What's another one?
Smell.
Smell.
Touch.
Touch.
And hearing.
And hearing, yay! Peanut kids! All right, so are you guys ready to jump into this? Yes.
Yes.
So my first one we're gonna talk about is sight. Now, faith is believing in something that you cannot see, right? So I can't see it.
I can't see it.
All right, so what do I have in my hands?
Feathers.
Feathers. All right, I'm going to give everybody a feather. Oops, I'm not going to give you that little one. Everybody gets a feather, okay? And we have some nice feathers that we're going to use. All right, everybody have a feather? Now, look at this feather very closely. All right, you just use one. Everybody have it? Now, I want you to put it in front of you, on top of you. We're going to blow this feather. You're going to blow it as best as you can. Everybody got it?
Yes.
Are you gonna blow it all over the table?
No.
Let's see who can keep it up. Are you ready? Ready, set, go. Did anybody try? Did it work?
Yeah.
All right, so here you go, Kat. It's okay. So everybody can see, if you don't have your feather anymore, that's okay. This feather, right? Did it get in the air by itself?
No.
What held up the feather?
Air.
Now, just because we can't see air, does that mean we don't believe in it? No, we know that something held it up, right? And that was air. Everybody do this. And breathe out. Air is what keeps us alive, right? And just like with Jesus Christ, we can't see that he's holding us up, but guess what? He is, right? He's similar to air. We can't see him holding us up in faith, but he does, right? What do you want to add on, Kylie?
It's like certain body parts like we can't see. Like we can't see our lungs, our heart, but we still know they're there.
We can't see our lungs and our heart, but we still know that they are there. And that's having faith. That's having faith that your heart is still going to work and keep you alive, right? All right, so now Mr. Kirk wants to show you something else that's very, very cool about faith. Are you guys ready?
Yes.
All right, come on, Mr. Kirk.
Okay, so just like we blew that feather up in the air, I'm going to use this normal hair dryer to hold this ball up in the air. And so you kind of get an idea of what Ms. Jo was talking about, of how Jesus kind of holds us up. You ready?
Mm-hmm. Do y'all think it's going to hold us up?
Yes.
Now, I don't... Sorry. I can't see the air, but I know that it's there, right? And just like this ball, who holds us up? Jesus Christ holds us up just like that ball, right?
And now...
And that's called power. Say power!
Power!
And so with Jesus, okay, everybody see that? With Jesus, this is what he really wants to do with our faith. So this is great. This is good. This is the beginning stages. But he wants us to increase our faith. He wants to take us to new heights. So even though we can't see him always holding us up like this, we also need to understand that with Jesus, with the power of Jesus, we can go further and farther.
Right? So with Jesus Christ, he's able to take us to new heights. Say new heights.
New heights.
And guess what? He can't take you there if you don't have faith. Because when we doubt who he is, guess what? It kills our faith. Say, don't doubt.
Don't doubt.
Are you guys ready for the next demonstration? So our demonstration number two, while using our five senses, is taste. And Mr. Kirk is going to help us understand how this works with our faith. Are you guys ready?
Yes!
Let's go.
All right, so what is this in my hand?
A lemon.
Okay, what do we know about lemons?
Sour.
What else?
Then they make your face like this.
Yeah, they make you make funny faces because they're so sour. Well, you've ever heard the expression, when life throws you lemons, make lemonade?
Yes.
Okay. So we're gonna use this lemon to represent life and how it can kind of throw us a curveball. It can kind of give us some trials and tribulations. It's not always sweet, right? Life sometimes is a little bit sour. Okay.
It makes us sad sometimes. Things happen that makes us sad and make us question God, and just sometimes things don't always go our way, right? We've all experienced it, right? So that's what we mean when we say life can give you lemons, all right?
Okay, and I already have a lemon cut up. Right? And this side, right, is gonna represent somebody without faith.
Say without faith.
Without faith.
Okay, and this side is gonna represent somebody with faith.
Say with faith.
With faith.
Okay, and so I already have some volunteers. Alex, you said you don't like lemons, right? Why don't you like lemons?
Say that again.
Why don't you like lemons?
They don't taste good.
No, they don't taste good at all, right?
Okay, so I want you to go ahead and take a taste of this. Now, don't eat it. Don't try to, like, swallow it. Just, you know how you kind of put oranges in your mouth and do that little silly stuff, right? Okay, just take, go ahead, grab it. Just take a little taste. Everybody watch his face.
All it takes is a little bit of faith. All it takes is a little bit of faith.
Let's just see. You can get rid of that.
All right, yeah. Alex, we're going to count you down. You ready? And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Well, watch his face. Watch his face. That's good. Just hold it. Okay, so remember, this is somebody without faith.
He doesn't have faith.
Okay, so you saw his face. That wasn't a good face. That's not a good life experience, right? Okay. All right, Micah.
All right, Micah. Same thing. All it takes is a little bit of faith.
Micah, just jump right into it. Just a little. Oh, never mind. Oh, you got a seed.
Whatever.
Okay. Micah likes it.
Okay.
So what does yours taste like? Micah, what does yours taste like?
Just lemon.
Just lemon.
A little bit
sweet.
Kind of.
Okay. So without faith, okay, we kind of go through life making that face and it's not pleasant. Life is a little bit sour. It hits us in a bad way. But with faith, okay, we might run into some seeds sometimes, but we still go after it. It's a little bit sweet. It tastes good. We like it. Okay. So with the second demonstration, now we're talking about taste, okay, even though life doesn't always taste great, with faith, we can still meet it with a happy face. We can still meet it and enjoy it, even though it's not always great every single day.
They say, taste and see that the Lord is good, because Micah is still on this limit.
He's killing it.
And we can see that for him, with faith, they both have the same thing. But for Micah, even though he has a lemon, he's still able to enjoy it. It's sour, but he's still able to enjoy it. And with faith, that's how we do it.
Whereas with Alex, he was looking at it, he didn't want no parts of that lemon after he was done.
All right, so that's our second demonstration. Are you guys ready for another demonstration? Guys, for demonstration number three, using our five senses, we're going to talk about the sense of smell. Say smell.
Smell.
Now I have my Kingdom Kids blindfolded because I don't want them to see what I have. All right, so I am going to put what I have in front of them, and then when I tell you guys to, do not say it, you're going to let me know what it is. All right, so I am going to come around the table and you get a chance to see,
just smell,
or smell, not see, what you think it is.
Just smell.
Smells.
Okay, I got it. Smell. Okay, we just smell.
Okay.
All right, so everyone had a chance to smell. Raise your hand if you think you know what it is. Kai has his hand up. What do you think it is, Kai?
I think it's oranges.
He thinks it's oranges. How many of you think it's oranges? Everybody raise your hand if you think it was oranges. You guys are correct. Do not take your blindfolds off. Now, let me ask you something. Since we're talking about faith, how many people who have had an orange before? Who's had an orange before? Everybody, right? So, because you could not see it, you recognized what it was, right? The reason why I use this for faith is sometimes we can't see God, but we know something he's done before, and we recognize it, right? If he's done a miracle in our lives, we don't have to say, I don't know if God can do miracles. I recognize his character. I recognize his ability, and I know that he can do it for me, even if I cannot see it, right? Everybody got it?
Yes.
Now, I'm gonna do one more thing and let's see if you can recognize it. I'm coming around.
Oh, ow.
Ooh.
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 Smell.
Just smell.
Don't smell nothing. Oh God, this
is smell. Smell.
Can I eat it?
Kylie.
Ew.
All right, so we have done our second round, and Chloe thinks that she knows what it is. What is it, Chloe?
Hot sauce.
Hot sauce. Let's see. Kylie.
I think it may be banana peppers.
Banana peppers. Anybody else?
Me.
Kai?
Just peppers.
Peppers. And what do you think, Alana?
Pickles.
Pickles. All right, so the winner was... Kai, it's peppers, and just like, you guys can take your blindfolds off.
Oh, fine.
Just like with the oranges, we know that. Why did you know that it was peppers, Kai?
It just smelled weird.
It smelled weird, but you knew that because you've already had an experience with peppers, right? So you were telling me the other day about an experience you heard with someone who's a singer, and you told me about that makes you have faith, and who was that person?
Travis Green.
Can you tell your friends what happened to Travis Green?
He fell out of a window, and then his mom called his name, called Jesus Christ's name 3 times, and then he rose back up again.
All right, so he rose back up. So Travis Green was almost dead, and God was able to bring him back to life. Now, because Kai knows that already, if something was to happen like that again, and we won't say it happens all the time, but he now has the faith to believe that Jesus can do it again. and our experiences help us to believe that Jesus Christ is able to help us, to save us, to do miracles, right? And so we want to make sure that we don't ever lose those experiences, those testimonies of what God can do. Do you guys understand?
Yes.
Yes? Do you understand, Kylie? Yes. All right, are you guys ready for our next demonstration? All right, Kingdom Kids, this is demonstration number 4 on faith. And now we're using our 5 senses, but this time we're using the sense of touch. Say touch.
Touch.
All right, and I have my friend Alana with me today. Alana, are you ready?
Yes.
All right, so Alana, what do I have in front of me?
A chair.
A chair. Is this chair your friend? No, it's not your friend? Okay. Do you like this chair?
Yes.
Do you use this chair?
Yes.
But it's not your friend?
No.
Okay, so she's just using a chair that's not her friend. All right, so why do you use this chair?
So you can sit down.
Okay, show me. She sat down, right? Now get back up. Do you trust this chair?
Yes.
Why?
The chair won't break.
So you trust that it's going to do what it said it can do, right? Which is to help you sit down and it won't break. Sit again. Did you think about why you wanted to sit? No, right? You didn't think about it. Get back up for me. She didn't think about why she wanted to sit in this chair because she had faith that this chair would do exactly what it said it would do. It didn't break. It held her up, and guess what? She didn't doubt that it would do it, right? Just like with Jesus Christ, with the chair, sit down. We have to put our weight on it. Say, weight on it.
Weight on it.
We put our weight on Jesus Christ, knowing that he will be there for us in whatever area that we need him to be there for us in, right? She wasn't afraid to sit down, and you shouldn't be afraid to trust Jesus Christ because he will hold you up. Say, hold me up, Jesus.
Hold me up, Jesus.
So I appreciate Alana showing us, stand up, Alana, that her friend, the chair, can hold her up. And who else is your friend, Alana?
Jesus.
Jesus Christ. Say, Jesus can hold me.
Jesus can hold me.
Because I can put my weight on him.
Because I can put my weight on him.
All right, we want you guys to know that it doesn't matter what it is that you're asking God for. God will come through. Just sit on him, put your weight on him, trust him, and have faith. Say, all you need is a little bit of faith.
Hit it.
All you need is a little bit of faith.
Are you ready for our next demonstration? All right, Kingdom Kids, we're on our last step of faith using our 5 senses, and that is the sense of hearing. Say hearing.
Hearing.
Faith comes by hearing. Now, I have Kylie with me today and Mr. Kirk. Now, her job is to listen to Mr. Kirk like we would listen to Jesus when we need guidance. And she has to listen to him to get to the end, to go on the road that Jesus has for her. But say, but she has a lot of distractions. Whose voice will she listen to? The voice of her friends, of Satan, or will she listen to the voice that will guide her? All right. Are you guys ready to see? Let's go.
All right, Kylie. All right. Turn to your right a little bit.
Go to the left.
Go forward. Walk straight. Walk straight. Walk straight. Stop. All right. Turn. Back up just a little bit. Back up a little bit more. Turn to your right. You're on the right. You're on the right. Go forward. All right. All right. Turn to your left a little bit. All right. Take one step forward. Okay. Hold on. Now, turn to your left just a little bit. All right. Walk in that direction you're facing. Keep going. Keep going. Keep going. Keep going. Keep going. Keep going. Nope. Stop. All right. Turn around. Turn around. All right. Take 3 steps forward. 1, 2, 3. Stop. Move to your left. Move to your left. Okay. Turn to your right a little bit. All right. Take 1 step forward. All right. Turn to your right. Turn to your right.
Turn left.
All right. Walk forward.
Turn left.
Keep going. Stop. Turn to your left just a little bit. Just a little bit. All right. Walk forward. Walk forward. All right, stop. Take a step to your right a little bit. All right. Go forward. Okay, good. Now turn to your left a little bit. Yep, now walk. The way you're facing, walk. Nope, nope, nope. That's, yeah, the way you're facing right now, walk. Okay, stop. Stop. All right, come to your left a little bit. A little bit more, a little bit more. All right, stop. All right, turn to your right just a little bit. Walk forward. Okay. Good job. Good job.
Holly was able to listen to God's voice to get her to the end, even though she had all of the distractions. We're so proud of you. Give me a high five. Good job, Kylie.
Promise over pressure. I ain't got no time for your shenanigans. I'm trying to make it into heaven. I ain't got no time to be playing with sin. You can mess me with.